Deflections in stresses. Deflections in stresses, okay. So suppose that problems will be like this. Suppose if there is a truss like this, loads are acting like this. These are joints. Suppose 20 kilonewtons, 30 kilonewtons, 10 kilonewtons loads are like this. A, B, C, D, E. So problems may be like this. Find vertical deflection at C. Maybe the cross sectional area of this member. A is something they will give. Okay, so many suppose 3 centimeter square area. So this also area, suppose 4 centimeter square. This for this area, suppose 3 centimeter square. So like this they will give, and Young's modulus also they will provide. Suppose E equal to steel, 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square. So they will ask to find deflection at C, vertical deflection at C, or horizontal deflection at C. So questions can be like this. Okay. So trusses here, we need to find deflections. Okay. Trusses may be carrying some loads, and truss elements will be having some cross sectional area and material property, Young's modulus. Okay. So having all these things, at any joint you can find vertical deflection as well as horizontal deflection at any joint. Okay, Srinivas, clear?
Yes, sir.
For a given structure, we need to find horizontal deflection or vertical deflection at any joint. That is our task now. So actually, we learned about deflections. We know. Five methods: moment area theorem, unit load method, strain energy method, double integration method, and what else? Conjugate beam method for beams. For trusses here, of course, similarly, we can use strain energy method here. So strain energy method. Strain energy method is suitable. Suitable for truss deflection calculations. Truss deflection calculations. Okay. So in strain energy, you know, for axially loaded members, strain energy equal to strain energy U equal to half into stress into strain into volume, right? Half into stress into strain into volume, or otherwise half into stress means P by A, strain means delta L by L, volume means area into length, or that is half into P into delta L. So that is the strain energy. Okay, for axially loaded members, this we can write like this also, that equal to half into P into delta L means PL by AE, that equal to P square L by 2AE. So actually AE is called axial rigidity. AE is called axial rigidity. So P square L by 2AE is the strain energy in any member. Okay, so now we need to find deflection using this strain energy method. Okay. Let us assume P suffix I is forcing ith member due to external loads. Okay, let unit load is applied at the point where deflection is required. Okay, and Ki is the force due to unit load in ith member. Okay, in ith member, K suffix I is the force in ith member due to unit load. Okay, suppose then the force in ith member due to imaginary load, suppose Q, imaginary load Q is, so force in ith member due to imaginary load Q is Q into Ki. Okay, right? For unit load force is, I mean, due to unit load force in any member is K, that is an ith member is Ki, then due to Q load obviously it would be K into Q into Ki. Okay, so like this, total strain energy we need to find sigma of half Pi plus Q Ki whole square into Li by A of I, then delta is dou U by dou Q, so just differentiating that we get delta equal to sigma PKL by AE. Okay, I'll show you a problem. Let us take a simple problem first. Okay, I will take very simple problem. Suppose this is the simple truss member. So this is 3 meter span. This is 60 degrees. This also 60 degrees, and it is carrying a load of 20 kilonewtons. Okay, and for all members, AE equal to, okay, area equal to 10 centimeter square for all members, area. Okay, and X modulus is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per millimeter square. Okay, find vertical deflection at C in mm. So this is the question. Okay, so first we need to analyze this member due to external loads. Of course here reactions are 10 kilonewton, 10 kilonewton, and here, okay, let's assume compression in these members. Okay, like this. Okay, so here force in AC into cos, here this angle is 30 degrees, right, with vertical. So force in AC into cos 30. Similarly, another force in BC into cos 30. That means we are using method of joints. Okay, at C must be equal to 20. So anyway, force in AC, force in BC both are same because of symmetry. 2 times of force in AC into cos 30. Cos 30 means root 3 by 2 equal to 20. So force in AC equal to here 2 to cancel 20 by root 3. That is the force in AC. So force in AB can be determined like this. So you can assume tension, yeah, tension in AB member. So mother of joints at A, force in AC into cos 60 is the horizontal component. Must be balanced by force in AB. So force in AC we know already 20 by root 3. Cos 60 is 1 by 2 equal to force in AB, which is equal, therefore force in AB equal to 10 by root 3 kilonewtons. 10 by root 3 kilonewtons, okay? So we got everything, because force in BC also, you know, force in AC, force in BC also same, force in BC also 20 by root 3 kilonewtons, but it is in compression, force in AC is compression, force in AB is tension, okay? Similarly, now unit load also we'll put under, we'll analyze that unit load, I mean truss. So this is this one. So we need vertical deflection at C, that's why we need to put a 1 newton, one load, okay, one unit load, no units, one unit, that's all. So for this, in similar manner, we can analyze this. This is 1 by 2, that is 0.5, this is 0.5. Here we can analyze, for 20 means 20 by root 3, 1 means 1 by root 3, force in this 1 by root 3. Here also 1 by root 3, okay? And in this, tension here is, force may be 10 by root 3 means here, 20 load was there, that time 10 by root 3. So here 0.5 by root 3 is the force AB due to unit load, okay? Because of 20 load, forces were analyzed. So because of one load means, one unit load means by 20. So here 0.5 by root 3. The force in AB due to this one is 0.5 by root 3. So now we'll form a table to evaluate that, okay? That is member P K L. AE, okay. Member AB, AC, BC. P, in AB member, P is AB, this one, 10 by root 3. Tension positive always, okay. AC, minus 20 by root 3. BC also, minus 20 by root 3. K means due to unit load. This is 0.5 by root 3. This one is minus 1 by root 3. This also minus 1 by root 3. Length everything is same, 3 meters. Okay, length. AE, so AE you can calculate, AE equal to 10 centimeter square. Centimeter square means 10 into 10 power 4. Sorry, one centimeter equal to 10 mm, so 100 into 100 millimeter square, right? 10 into 100 multiplied by 2 into 10 power 5. That equal to 2 into 10 power 8 newtons is the AE value, okay? Area in mm square and E newton per square, total newtons, that equal to 2 into 10 power 5 kilonewtons is the AE value. So this is 2 into 10 power 5, this also 2 into 10 power 5, this also 2 into 10 power 5. So now PKL by AE, value. Okay. So PKL is how much? R A is common. Go calculate only PKL. PKL. P into K into L. So that is 10 into 0.5. That is 5. 3 gets cancelled. 20 into 1. That is 20. Here also 20. That is PKL. Sigma PKL how much? 30. 50. 45, right? Sigma PKL is 45. Sigma PKL by AE. AE is common. So 45 divided by 2 into 10 power 5. Okay. Which is equal to 45 by 2, 22.5 into 10 power minus 5 meters, which is equal to 22.5 into 10 power minus 2 millimeters, that equal to 0.225 mm is the vertical deflection at a C. Okay. This is the way of calculation of this deflection of process. Okay. So I will solve one more problem. I will solve one simple problem, one more simple problem. Ten kilonewtons, 2 meter, 30 degrees. Okay, this is the configuration. Okay. AE value, parity value, AE value. 2 into 10 power 4 kilonewtons is the AE value. Okay. AE together value I have given. Find. Vertical deflection. This is A, B, C, D, E. At E. In millimeters. This is the question. Okay. So of course we need to analyze the stress first. So easily we can see the force in CD will be zero because three members are meeting at C. out of three, two are in line and the third one is alone. There is no pair for that. So CDA force will be zero. And then by using method of joints, we can conclude that the force in DE must be compressive because the vertical component in DE must be balanced with 20. So easily by using method of joints, force in DE, vertical component means sine 30 must be equal to 20. So FDE sine 30 is 1 by 2 equal to 20. So force in DE equal to 40 kilonewtons. Force in DE, this is 40. Okay. Now comparing horizontal components, at joint E, method of joints we can apply. So obviously tension will be there in CE. In CE tension means, so the balance is like this. Force in DE into cos 30 equal to force in CE. Okay. So 40 into cos 30 is root 3 by 2 equal to force in CD. So therefore force in CD equal to 20 root 3 kilonewtons. So here 20 root 3. Okay. Then to find force in AC easily, because joint C is suitable. So by using joint C, so tension away from joint like this. So this also 20 root 3. So now what else? Force in so obviously force in AD, BD, AB, three members are there. Okay. So how to analyze this? This angle will be, now this angle also 30 degrees, right? Because same, this also 2 meters. So this angle also 30 degrees. So now how to get force in AD? Any idea? In simple manner. Okay, take moment support B and get horizontal reaction at A. Horizontal reaction at A. That means take moment support B, 10 into 2 plus 20 into 4 equal to HA into, so what is this height actually? Can you guess this AB distance? So tan 30 equal to opposite side by same side. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So tan 30 equal to that AB distance divided by 4. So 1 by root 3 equal to AB by 4. So AB equal to 4 by root 3. This distance is 4 by root 3. So HA into 4 by root 3. So HA equal to this 20 plus 80, 100. 100 root 3 by 4. That equal to 25 root 3. Horizontal reaction here. 25 root 3. Obviously, here same, because some of the horizontal forces must be zero. At B also, reaction will be 25 root 3. So now, what would be the angle here? Okay, this angle is 60 degrees, right? This angle is 60 degrees. So by using method of joints, okay. And see here, this must be compression in BD. So by analyzing force in BD multiplied by horizontal component sine 60, right, equal to 25 root 3. So force in BD into sin 60 is root 3 by 2 equal to root 3. Force in BT equal to 50 kilonewton. Clear? This is 50. Okay. 15 kilonewtons, right? 50. Then one more. Okay. AB also you can work out. AB means force in AB. Obviously, you can guess. That is, that must be, see, BD compression means AB must be tension. Like this. So force in BD, force in AB equal to force in BD multiplied by cos 60. Force in BD 50, cos 60 1 by 2, that equal to 25 kilonewtons. Okay. So this is 25. So now we need only one thing, that is AD. See, AD vertical component should be matched with 25. That's why it must be compression. It must be compression, and the force is like this. If force in AD into the component, vertical component, sine 30 equal to 25, because force in AD 25. So force in AD, sine that is 1 by 2, so 50 kilonewtons. So AD is 50, okay? Right? Everything is fine, I think. Vertical components are getting balanced. Now, analyze unit load, this one, truss. A, B, C, D, E, 30 degrees. So we need to put a unit load here. That's all. One unit load. Okay. And analyze. See here, of course, this will be zero. Then here it must be compression. Obviously, this is, so the 20 was there, then that time it was 40. That means now it is 2. Okay. Now similarly, so tension should be there in CE. That is that 40 corresponds 20 root 3, 2 corresponds just root 3. You can check it, okay? Then here also same tension root 3. Then here reaction is here, couple, this distance is 4 by root 3, okay, distance. So obviously taking moments about B, 1 into 4 equal to HA into 4 by root 3. HA equal to 1 by root 3. So this is 1 by root 3. This also 1 by root 3. So now compression must be there here. So 1 by root 3 should be balanced with this 50, I mean, sorry, force in BD into that KBD, okay? Into what is that angle? This 60 degrees means. What is the equation? Force in BD, K, I will call KBD. KBD multiplied by horizontal component sine 60 equal to 1 by root 3. KBD equal to sine 60 root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2, 2 by 3, right? KBD is 2 by root 3. 2 by 3. Because root 3 by 2, 2 by root 3. That is 2 by 3. KBD is 2 by 3. Srinivas, correct? Huh?
Okay, sir.
Now, this angle is 30 degrees. Horizontal. So at joint this one, I think where we did mistake.
Sir, I could sign the cos. Okay.
Where?
Sir, H is root 3, sir. H is root 3.
H A is root 3.
Yes, sir.
H A is root 3. Okay, sorry. H A is root 3. H A is root 3 means here also we need to change. Root 3. So here root 3 into 2 by, that is 2 now, right? This is 2. KBD is 2 only. KBD is 2. So at joint A, we missed one reaction. That's why FAD sine 30 should be equal to not 25. That is net is upward means that also the direction also wrong here. Sorry. Now net force is 30 minus 25. 5. 5 is upward direction means that must be tension here now. Here, tension, because at joint A, 30 upward, 25 downward. So, net upward means to get balance that in AD, tension should be there. How much is that? FAD sine 30 equal to 5. Okay, FAD equal to 5 into 2, 10. This is 10. Now you will get, I think. Srinivas, correct? Huh? Now? 50.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now in this, similarly here, here vertical reaction will be now here. Here what A vertical reaction is now 1 unit. Now here, 2 into cos 60 is 1. That should be balanced with this AB. So in AB, it must be tensile away from. So this 1. Okay. Now 1 and 1 vertical get balanced means, otherwise you see a joint D. By seeing a joint D, no other, I mean, one force already becomes 0, which is joining a D. Now only 3 members are there. So obviously in this member also force 0. So now you got everything right. So now you can form a table. How many members are there totally? I'll make a table here.
7.
Member P, K, L. Okay. See, wherever zero force members are there in unit load structure, those members no need to consider. So AC we need to consider, CE we need to consider, DE we need to consider, BD we need to consider, AB we need to consider. Okay. So P force in AC, AC P force how much? That was 20 root 3, right?
20 root 3.
CE 20 root 3. DE 40. So tension take positive. 40 compression means minus 40. BD compression 50 minus 50. AB tension 25. So K force, AC tension root 3, CE tension root 3, DE compression 2, BD compression 2, AB tension 1. So lengths, okay. Lengths actually AC length 2 meters, CE length 2 meters, DE length. Can you tell DE length? DE length. Sine 30, cos 30. 2 by x equal to cos 30, root 3 by 2. How much?
2.31.
Tell me fraction. 2 by x equal to 30.
4 by root 3, sir.
4 by root 3. BD also same? AB also same. 4 by root 3. So these are the lengths, okay. Now PKL value also we will calculate. PKL. So how much PKL? 20 root 3 root 6, 60, 120, yeah? Then also, this also 120. Here 80 into 4, 320. 100, 400 by root 3. 25, 100 by root 3. Sigma 240 plus 500 by root 3. So now delta equal to how much? Sigma PKL by AE. That equal to 240 plus 820 by root 3 divided by AE value 2 into 10 power 4. How much it is?
Zero point 0.0356
meters, which is equal to 35.6 millimeters. 35.6 millimeters is the answer. See this? Okay. Find horizontal deflection. At C in millimeters. Okay. This is a very simple problem which can be asked in gate exam. Okay. I will solve this. So at joint C, by seeing this, the force in BC must be compression like this towards joint. So let us assume this is theta angle. So cos theta equal to 4 by 5, sin theta equal to 3 by 5. Okay. Now, force in BC into sin theta must be equal to 30. So force in BC, sin theta is 3 by 5 equal to 30. So force in BC equal to 50 kilonewtons. Similarly, at joint C, force in BC into cos theta must be equal to force in AC. That force in AC, obviously it should be tension. Okay. Force in AC. So force in AC equal to force in BC 50, cos theta is 4 by 5. So 40 kilonewtons. Okay. Force in AC. Only two members are there here. So take unit load. Please remember structure. So we need to find horizontal deflection. That's why put one unit load here like this. Okay. AB, C. See, obviously this one kilonewton load, I mean one unit load and AC member are in a line and BC is in another line. Obviously, force in this will be zero and force in AC will be tensile and it is one. Okay. So KAC, K equal to one, KAC equal to one. Okay. Now, remember P, K, L, A, E. Remember P, K, L, area, E and P, K, L by A, E. Okay. Now remember only two members are there. AC, BC. AC, P, how much? AC, 40. AC tensile, okay. BC compression 50, so minus 50. K value AC tensile 1, this is 0. Length, this one is 4 meters, this is 5 meters. Area 2 centimeter square in centimeter square, in millimeter square it is 200. This is 300. E 2 into 10 power 5. I mean in meter, okay, no problem, 10 power 5, okay, that you will get in newtons actually. P also if you put in newtons into 10 cube. Okay, now PKL by E, what happens? First one, 40 into 10 cube into 1 into 4 by AE. 200 into 200 and power 5. Equal to how much? Anyway, this is 0. That is how much?
Four into 10 power minus 3.
4 into 10 power
minus 3.
Minus 3. So total sigma PKL by A also equal to 4 into 10 power minus 3. This is in meters, that equal to 4 millimeters. Okay. 4 millimeters is the horizontal deflection at C. So I will give some assignment. Find this also 3 meters length. Okay. 2 centimeters square, 2 centimeters square. Take E equal to 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square. Find horizontal deflection at C. Next step.
సార్ అది అన్స్టేబుల్ అవ్వదా సార్
అవ్వదా సారీ నేను యా బోత్ ఆర్ ఇంగ్లీష్ Find horizontal deflection at D. 4. Find vertical deflection at C. Next. find horizontal deflection at C. ఈ ఫైవ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ చేయండి అంటే త్రీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ యాక్చువల్గా డబుల్ డబుల్ వచ్చాయి కదా అవి చేయండి. డౌట్స్ ఏం లేవు, క్లియర్గా ఉన్నారా ఇదంతా?